Sengkang and Punggol LRT lines are two automated transit lines serving townships in the northeast of Singapore. With a length of 10 kilometers each, Sengkang and Punggol LRT are two separate LRT lines serving the township of Sengkang and Punggol while sharing the same depot. Once envisioned as the solution of the missing gap between bus and MRT, the automated LRT lines linking the housing flats and local facilities to Sengkang and Punggol MRT stations. What are the reasons that these two LRT lines were built, why the branch to Punggol North was never built, and why there's no more LRT after 2005? Let's take a ride on an automated pod and understand more of the LRT system in Sengkang and Punggol. Automated pods that carry the people from their houses to the destination is a futuristic idea that often appeared in the 20th century urban design publications. The pods that carry the passengers to their destination without any driver on board and any staff in the station. Expectation of dense development of flats, curbing the ownership of cars and future-proofing caused the construction of two lines of automated people mover, or in Singapore, LRT, or light rail transit. To understand the need of the LRT serving these two townships, we need to look back at the time where Sengkang and Punggol townships were on the planning stage. Sengkang got its name from Lorong Sengkang, one of the kampung streets that used to exist in the area. Originally, the area was named Kangka due to the area was dotted with fishing jetties or Kangka. The name did not die out. Kangka is one of the stations in Sengkang LRT. Because of its distance from the city, about 10 miles or 16 kilometers, Sengkang maintains its rural atmosphere until the early 1990s. Meanwhile, Punggol is derived from the nearby Sungai Punggol. Originally a collection of kampung and fishing jetties, Punggol was once the last remaining rural areas in Singapore before being earmarked as a new township in the early 1990s. Punggol 21 was mentioned in the National Day Rally 1996, where Punggol will be the role model of the 21st century township and the later townships to follow. Planned after the implementation of Certificate of Entitlement of COE in 1990, both Sengkang and Punggol townships are designed to minimize car dependency, while each township served by one MRT station. Because of the distance and rurality, the new township location at the Ulu by Sungai Punggol and Sungai Serangoon caused the need of a modern, efficient and futuristic transit solution to attract the home buyers. Hence, the need of an LRT to connect the passengers between MRT and the flats. Thus, Sengkang and Punggol townships are developed with transit-oriented development in mind. Transit-oriented development, or TOD, is a type of development that integrates the transit systems within the development planning. As a result, LRT were built together with the main avenues in Sengkang and Punggol before the flats and public amenities were built. Some of the LRT stations are awkwardly standing in the middle of cleared open areas such as in Punggol Point. Sengkang LRT was opened on 80th of January 2003 with the opening of the East Loop, which is 6 months earlier than MRT line that the LRT line intersect with. MRT North East Line is the line that intersect with Sengkang and Punggol LRT lines, was opened on 20th of June 2003, 6 months later. As the first automated MRT line and the third automated transit line in Singapore, Northeast Line has its own interesting history, topic for another video. Meanwhile, Punggol LRT East Loop was opened on 29th of January 2005, while the West Loop was opened on 29th of January 2014. The reason of the 9 years gap is due to the time awaiting the development of the areas as the land slowly develops. The cost to construct Sengkang and Punggol LRT is about 650 million Singaporean dollars. LRT in Singapore is not the same as the LRT in the rest of the world. I talk about the oddities of Bukit Panjang or LRT Bukit Panjang in the previous video, where this LRT system is actually a people mover, while the LRT elsewhere around the world could be a full functioning metro system or a tram. The link to watch this video will be appeared. There are similarities with Sengkang and Punggol LRT lines and their sibling in Bukit Panjang. All LRTs in Singapore are fully automated and no driver on board. Automatic. The LRT stations are smaller than MRT and no escalator throughout the system except in two stations, Sengkang and Punggol MRT-LRT interchange. To reduce the need of manpower further, LRT stations are often automated as well with self-service ticket machine and cashless ticket gates. Therefore, it's really hard to see any staff on site in the station except in Sengkang and Punggol stations. However, there are differences that makes the ride in Sengkang and Punggol LRT lines feel smoother and stabler than in Bukit Panjang. Number 1, the rolling stock. Sengkang and Punggol LRT use Mitsubishi Crystal Mover, the same model that been used as Changi Airport Skytrain since 2006. I talked about Changi Airport in the previous video and how the airport sustained its position as one of the best airports in the world. The link to watch this video will flying above. Crystal Mover is smoother due to side guide, which makes the train sway less, unlike in Bukit Panjang. And number 2, the tracks. Crystal Mover moves on a concrete track with rubber tires, but the trip is impressively smooth because of the side guide. In addition, Sengkang and Punggol LRT are built on a flat area without grid change in contour, an advantage that Bukit Panjang LRT do not have. Originally, Punggol LRT should have one branch that branched off from Tech Lee Station towards Punggol North Avenue in the east. By noticing carefully on the left side of the track after some key station, there is an abandoned switch that's supposed to lead towards Punggol North Avenue. The plan to build an LRT branch existed in Master Plan 2003 and 2008 published by Urban Redevelopment Authority or URA, but disappeared in the Master Plan 2014. Why was the Punggol North branch was never built? It took 9 years between East Loop and West Loop of Punggol LRT to open, and even today, not all stations are open, such as Tech Lee Station, 20 years after the station was built. Unlike MRT station, where the adjacent land is more desirable to be developed as commercial areas or the campus of Singapore Institute of Technology or SIT, as in Punggol Coast due to high pedestrian traffic, LRT tracks cost more than a road with bus stops and cycle lane, which is make more sense in a new development area. As a result, it is cheaper and more convenient to build a road with bus lane and cycle lane. These are the reasons that Punggol North branch was never built and the cause of the cancellation of the LRT lines island-wide. As explained in the previous video about Bukit Panjang LRT, there are several issues that caused Sengkang and Punggol LRT lines become the last LRT lines in Singapore, together with the abandonment of Punggol North branch and other planned LRT lines. Number 1 is the cost. Of course, LRT system is cheaper to build than MRT, but LRT is more expensive to maintain than maintaining a road with bus lane and cycle lane. Maintaining a transit system is not cheap. Rolling stocks, tracks, station, depot, signalling and safety features. Just to get the idea of the cost, Land Transport Authority or LTA spent 439 million Singaporean dollars for 17 two-car sets on February 2022 to increase the capacity of Sengkang and Punggol LRT. That figure is not including 87 million Singaporean dollars for additional 8 two-car sets ordered in 2023. Often, the LRT stations are standalone structure, unlike the MRT where the surrounding area are attractive to be developed as a commercial area, covering a part of the MRT construction cost. Number 2, the tracks. Unlike in Bukit Panjang, the track layout of LRT in Sengkang and Punggol are incorporated within township planning based on URA Master Plan 2003. As a result, most of the LRT stations are located in the road median, and when the lines were opened back in 2003 and 2005 respectively, stations often stand in the middle of nowhere awaiting the future development. Sengkang and Punggol located at a flat land, making the ride smoother and less of a roller coaster feel as in Bukit Panjang. In addition, the rolling stock used in Sengkang and Punggol has side guide, which allows faster operating speed of 70 km/h, stable carriage and avoiding the wheels to fall down to the street below because it happened at Bukit Panjang. Number 3, the stations. The LRT stations at Sengkang and Punggol are similarly designed with each other, with one big difference with Bukit Panjang. All of the standalone LRT stations have island platform since the stations stand in the middle of the road. As with Bukit Panjang LRT, no escalators, limiting the number of passengers going up and down from platform. And the issue does not stop at the standalone LRT station. Both Sengkang and Punggol MRT stations are integrated with the LRT under one roof. Going upstairs to the LRT platform, there are two platforms that the indicator will light up either east or west when a train is approaching. Each of the platforms serving two different loops either to the west or to the east. Confused? I am. The situation is similar in both stations as Sengkang and Punggol stations are similarly designed. LRT above ground, MRT underground. Imagine the confused passengers if Punggol LRT served by Punggol North branch that use the same track as the West Loop services that share the same platform with the East Loop services. As in 2024, Sengkang LRT station platforms were upgraded to allow the trains to stop at four different waiting areas at two platforms instead of the current two waiting areas: west clockwise, east counterclockwise, and west counterclockwise and east clockwise. Other than better platforms, Sengkang and LRT Punggol LRT lines received more trains as the passenger number increased. 60 newer two-car trains were ordered, and by 2017, all the new trains were in service. Due to rapid development of Sengkang and Punggol townships, 17 more new two-car trains were ordered. 8 more added, 25 in total. 25 new two-car trains are expected to enter the service starting in 2024, together with enlargement of LRT depot. After the completion of Punggol LRT West Loop in 2014, there is no more new LRT lines in the whole island. If LRT is not available in the new townships, how do the people travel from their homes, their houses, to the nearest MRT station? Number 1. Cycling. With the policy of walk, cycle, ride, Singapore encouraged cycling as one of the strategies to reduce the car dependency. Cycling today is more pleasant than 10 years ago, with the amenities of cycle lane, bicycle parking which is often free, and the ability to carry folded bike in MRT and LRT trains. Instead of waiting for LRT or bus that might arrive every 15 minutes, cycling could be done anytime, especially at night and weekends. In addition, cycling does not need formalities such as driving license, insurance or COE unless you ride an e-bike, which or its official name, power assisted bicycle. You need to have a license plate. Other than convenience, the low cost of maintaining a bicycle is unbeatable, mainly for tire patches, chain and brake. Cycling is practical for 10-minute cycle trip and not suitable for cross-city travel. I cycled from Orchard to Bradel when the MRT broke down many years before. It took about 1 hour of cycling to cover the distance of 10 minutes of MRT ride. If you insist to travel in all weather condition, that is number 2, bus. Bus service cover the whole island, including places where a few tourists ever visited, such as Punggol Beach. Until the late 1990s, the dead end of Punggol Road is the bus interchange until the development of Punggol Township, where the bus service terminates at the Punggol Bus Interchange next to MRT LRT station. Bus no longer serve Punggol Road as I remembered a few years back, and replaced with the new bus stops at New Punggol Road, east of the old road. There is a girl that helped me catch bus 84 that previously stopped at Punggol Road and now using the new road nearby. You might not watch this video, she might not watch this video, but thank you for saving 30 minutes of my life. Unlike LRT, buses are able to connect township to another township or to the city via expressways, and often bus services terminate near MRT stations. Number 3, new MRT lines. Despite the cost of building two underground MRT stations is enough to build an LRT line, building new MRT lines is preferable over LRT due to several factors. Train and platform capacity of MRT is higher than LRT, underground station conserve the limited land in Singapore and ability to integrate with the future development. Often MRT stations do have bus interchange that bring the passengers to their destination, including in Punggol. Because of the interchangeability with bus and commercial development around MRT station that repays part of the MRT construction cost, no wonder MRT is financially feasible in the long term. MRT Jurong Region Line was planned as an LRT line at first but changed to MRT in 2013. Unlike LRT stations, there are escalators in MRT stations. The Punggol LRT branch to Punggol North was cancelled in favour of MRT Punggol Coast and Punggol North Bus Interchange, a single MRT station that replaced the whole branch of LRT. The similar situation in the new township of Bidadari, where infill station of Woodlake was opened in 2011. No LRT in Bidadari and the township are covered by buses from Woodlake Bus Interchange. I visited Bidadari in my previous adventure, here is the video if you want to watch. Similar with Tengah Township, which is under construction as in 2024, connectivity via Jurong Region MRT and bus services, again no LRT. Thus, the new townships did not experience the Punggolization LRT lines with loops running between the flats. At the end, the automated LRT lines is no longer viewed as futuristic as it was perceived in the late 1990s, in a time when LRT was planned to cover the townships across Singapore. The flexibility and cost of cycling, the frequent bus, and the capacity and speed of MRT makes the LRT system no longer favorable in the current time and in the future, making Sengkang and Punggol LRT lines the last of its kind in Singapore. If you want to ride either Sengkang LRT or Punggol LRT, the line serves two townships of Sengkang and Punggol. Take note its line to the end of the line as Sengkang is the second last station and Punggol is the last. By 2025, Punggol Coast up northeast is the terminus of NEL. Bus serve the locality of Sengkang and Punggol to the nearby townships and other parts of Singapore such as Sembawang, Serangoon and Tampines. Both townships are served by only one expressway, Tampines Expressway. That is how efficient the transit system is. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something new about LRT in Sengkang and Punggol as the last of its kind. Thank you so much again and see you in the next video.